Okay, so I am fairly new to TikTok, right? And I was just flicking through and I came across some like medical advice. Initially, I thought this is questionable, but then I thought this is just outright dangerous. So here we are with the worst ones that I found. Okay, let me hit you up with the first one.
First one, heart. You're gonna pound the inside. These are the nerves that connect it to your heart. You're gonna slap your arm, slap your arm, slap it, okay? This is benefiting the heart.
Still sounds the same. There are no nerves there that are connected to your heart, okay?
For your digestive system, you're gonna do the cha-cha. You're gonna do the cha-cha for your digestive system. This is for your spleen, your stomach, for the liver.
The spleen is not even a digestive organ, guys. It's an organ that sits behind your stomach or close to your stomach, and it stores blood cells, so like red blood cells, white blood cells. It is not in any way involved in digestion, so I don't know what the cha-cha's doing for that. And I think with that, I'm kind of done with this video.
They don't want us to know that we can heal ourselves. They don't want us to know that through a simple lifestyle.
Okay, so this seems to be another water is toxic for you, everyone's trying to kill you video.
Only putting a band-aid on the problem, never healing. They don't.
Okay, wait. I haven't actually seen this video before, right? Some of them have been like sent to me. This is one of them. And I just have a feeling right now that she's gonna try and tell us something.
But the highly processed food, the highly processed sugar is what is caused.
Oh, there you go. See, my medical grade water heals you. Wow, what a statement. Anyways, let's actually get into the science of this video. I see lots and lots of things out there about not consuming acidic things. And let me tell you one thing, okay? Your body works around the clock to make sure that your pH is between a very, very tight range. So that's 7.35 to 7.45. And the reason it does that is because all of our cells and enzymes and so on work at an optimum at that pH. So you can't change that by ingesting acidic things or anything alkaline, because your body just does that for you naturally. Also, what is healing water? I wonder if it will help my sore back.
Why does it look like a walnut? Look at the grooves and like the dividing piece on the inside. Like, walnuts are actually the one nut that are really good for brain health. They prevent cognitive decline and just, it's freaking me out.
So I had to include this in there because coming from a Turkish background, my parents are always on about the fact that walnuts look like the brain, and for that reason, they are really, really good for your brain. And I had a little read up about this. And it turns out that there has been lots of studies into this, believe it or not, and they have found that those that are at a higher risk of cognitive decline may benefit from this, but there is no conclusive data. However, those healthy individuals haven't actually seen any beneficial differences. So the jury is still out, but it's still very interesting.
Why does a hot bath burn more belly fat than jogging for an hour?
It doesn't.
Why I stopped drinking water and why you should too?
Okay. Do not stop drinking water, okay? That is literally one of the most important things that the human body needs, aside from food. We will die earlier if we were dehydrated than if we were to live without food. Anyways, let's see what she's got to say.
Chlorine, all the other shit. There's also something called phthalates.
Phthalates.
So what are phthalates? Why do we care? Let's go. Last video, we talked about the pineal gland and our connection to source. This video, we're going to get a little bit more physical. Pineal gland is also responsible for our hormones and our endocrine system.
So the pineal gland that she's referring to is actually a small gland in the brain that only really is known for secreting melatonin, which is the hormone that's involved in sleep. Majority of the hormones that are secreted within the brain come from the hypothalamus, which then feeds to the pituitary gland, which then secretes all of their hormones that then affect other things in our body, like the thyroid and our ovaries and our adrenal glands and so on. And also, this research paper that she's referring to, the conclusion of that particular study is that the phthalates that she's referring to that you sometimes can find in bottled water actually have no effect on these people's health. And if anything, it concludes that plastic water bottles are not a major contributor of phthalates found in the human body.
Is what regulates your hormones. Hormones literally control everything. All of these things keep you at a lower vibration. When we're at a low vibration, we attract more.
Wait, what? I thought she was actually going somewhere with this. lower vibration.
Low vibration, low energy frequencies. In your spiritual journey, you want to raise your frequency.
Wait. How do we get from drinking water to an imbalance of hormones to a raising your frequency? Like, what even is this? Anyways, I want to watch to the end because I'm really curious as to see how she's going to conclude this.
So that you're more connected to source and so that you attract more high frequency people, vibes, everything. We cannot do that with a calcified pineal gland.
Okay, so apparently now the pineal gland is calcified. I need to take a break because this misinformation, and it's not even misinformation, this information is just making me dizzy. Just give me a moment. Okay, are you ready for more?
You've been using your ears wrong.
Oh my God, maybe all this time my ears could actually breathe for me. So when I got a blocked nose from having a cold, my ears could just breathe as like an extra airway. How did I not know this?
The right and left actually have different functions. Like if you're somewhere loud and trying to hear what someone is saying, you're more likely to succeed if you lean in with your right ear. But if you're trying to figure out what's playing on the radio, tilt your left ear towards the music.
No. There is no evidence for that. Next. Do you know, when I basically downloaded this video, the main thing, okay, so there's lots of misinformation I'm going to go into about why, but the main thing that got me was the lady's face. Like, why is it that she's like this throughout the whole video, right? She's like, and then she's massaging the legs and it's like, why? She must be camera shy. Anyways. Did you know that you can be holding 5 to 7 kilos of waste in your colon? No, not really. Unless you're like extremely constipated. And when I mean extremely, I mean like you haven't pooped for days on end and you've got a massive blockage going on. You don't have 5 kilos worth of poop in your colon, okay? You just don't. And if you do, that means you're in quite serious trouble and you need to really be seeing someone to disimpact all of that poop, because that's just going to stretch your rectum and it's going to cause even more constipation. Anyway, so for those who don't know, a colonic is basically where they stick a tube up your back passage. They put in like sort of warm water-ish, those kind of things, and flush out your digestive system. And let me tell you how dangerous this is, because the fluid that they put in there, if it's not the right consistency with your body, remember that our body fluid is a bit more on the salty side, it's not just pure water, so it can really affect the balance of the fluids and electrolytes within your body and can cause dehydration and even in worst case scenarios, death. And the fact that they're actually putting this tube up your back passage can lead to things like infections and perforation of your rectum. Yes, you heard that right. And there is no evidence for any of these colonics. And the people who often perform these aren't medically trained. Oh my God, this is the synthol guy on TikTok. Oh God, this is so painful to watch. So basically, synthol is this substance that people inject deep into their muscles. So basically, it's kind of like an implant. You inject it in there to make them look bigger. It doesn't actually do anything to the muscle itself. So the muscles are still pretty weak if they're weak to start off with. And apart from looking ridiculous, it's actually quite dangerous because if you inject this on a nerve, then you're going to get nerve damage. And if you inject it into a blood vessel, you're going to block that blood vessel and all of the areas that it supplies. So you're going to have like necrotic arms, necrotic whatever you do to inject it. So it really upsets me to see that these things are glamorized and videos like this have so many likes. But yeah, please, please, please do not do this.
Okay, so there's a big difference.
Okay, but tell me.
I'll talk about two main differences, okay? So clearly you do not inhale cigars, okay? It's just a puff, it never goes into your lungs. See, simple.
That kind of looked like it went into your lungs, mate.
So your lungs are safer. They're not safe, they're safer with cigars. Second, cigarettes have so many added chemicals, so many different bad things, while cigars are pure tobacco. There is nothing else.
Okay, let me just explain something to you. The difference between cigars and cigarettes. So cigarettes are tobacco wrapped in paper, and cigars are tobacco wrapped in tobacco leaf or paper that contains tobacco. So essentially, it's the same thing. And if anything, cigars are bigger and they're wrapped in tobacco on the outside as well. So they're actually more dangerous than cigarettes if you were to do a direct comparison. And cigars are known to cause more oral cancer compared to cigarettes. So basically, this information that he's portraying is just complete BS as well. Oh my God, earwax candling. I see this everywhere. The funny thing is, you know, the wax that you see, so it basically, it's trying to tell you that you set this thing alight near your ear and it sucks out the earwax perfectly in that sort of round cylinder shape, and it just deposits that within the candle. It's complete nonsense. The bit of sort of brown that you see is actually just the wax residue, and it has no suction power to remove any of your earwax. And it's actually quite dangerous because if any of the candle was to drip onto your ear and your earlobe, you're going to get really bad burns. So save your money, save your ears, and just don't do this. The best thing you can actually do to remove earwax at home is just to put a drop of olive oil into each ear to help soften the earwax, and when it's ready, it can just come out itself. If it's completely impacted, then you can do the same thing and you can go to your doctor who will refer you to have it sort of suctioned out.
So apparently if you have a teaspoon of olive oil before you go out, you don't get drunk. So
okay, so there is a little bit of fact in this, and the reason being, this is also the reason behind why people say you need to line your stomach before you go out drinking. Because roughly 20% of the alcohol is absorbed from our stomach and the remaining 80% is absorbed in our intestines. Now, if you ingest something fatty, so fatty food, or in this case, she's having a spoon of olive oil, then the stomach is going to digest that for longer and longer and longer, and it's not going to release that as quickly as it would into the intestines. So by having olive oil before you go out to drink means that the alcohol stays in your stomach for longer and it takes a little bit longer to enter your intestines so that you don't have that quick sort of absorption and whoop, drunk feeling. Let me see if it works for her.
Okay, 1 hour update. Usually I start feeling a little bit like stomach sick, not drunk, but stomach sick after a couple drinks, and I haven't at all and I don't really feel anything. So
yeah, kind of makes sense. I mean, I don't recommend this. I wouldn't say have a spoonful of olive oil and just go out drinking, but I'm just saying that the science does agree with that. But yeah, always stick to the recommended units, because it's not an achievement to be able to drink loads and loads and loads and not get drunk. It's just not.
Boner, we're in Spanish class.
To get it to go away, you can
try pushing your feet into the floor. It's gonna redirect the blood away from that area.
You, by digging your heels into the floor like that, all it's really doing is just distracting you. It's not essentially like opening up a gateway that drains the blood that's gone to your penis. It just doesn't work that way. It's mainly through distraction. And I mean, you could try it, it's no harm. But another way is to go and take a pee. There you go, guys, busting myths and beating misinformation. I really hope that you enjoy this video. If you did, I'd love for you to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. I'd love to have you as a viewer to watch more videos like this and loads of other things about my life as a doctor. That being said, I'll see you in my next video, guys. Bye.